Hello, what is? My name is Lily Control, and welcome back to Felix Wright Justice Brawl. We are going to hear testimony of Frosted the Killer. So, yeah.
There is something I must first state. To an assassin, nothing is more important than the trust between a client and myself, and that is the reason I am here today on the witness stand. It is my wish that you grasp this concept before you give it the name of the client.
That's not even a testimony. Mr. The Killer seems to be a very clever man. It doesn't say he seems to be mocking us.
While we may appear to be our enemy owner, Mr. The Killer is only stating the truth. He is no hypocrite. He has always stood by his full belief.
You mean about this trust between his client and himself thing?
It seems to be a level of trust beyond the people like me can comprehend.
Well, Mr. Wright, are you ready to cross-examine the witness?
Yes, Your Honor.
This is no way to know what's going next, so stay cool and collected, Felix.
We can hear everything you can say later. Can you please tell us your clients?
I don't think you understand your place, Mr. Tony. I said this is something I must first state. Do you even know the word first means?
Go on.
What is this response? You can't match your Mr. Wright. That's only because you don't know about my situation.
The trust between you and your client?
Provide my services in a fast and efficient manner. In exchange, I trust that my clients are discreet about me and my identity. If the many people knew my face, it would be quite troublesome.
And that is why you testify this manner?
This is the first time one of my clients has ever been accused for murder. I must preserve that the killer name so my clients can trust me.
But couldn't someone stab you in the back and break your trust?
It has never happened before, but if it ever did...
Yes?
That person would be my client for very long. They would certainly...
That's enough! Please put no more!
Very well, it was only hypocritical anyway. And that is the reason I am here today of the witness stand.
That seems a little strange to me. I mean, you're about to tell us the name of the client. I would think that this would be very bad for them.
It doesn't matter to me. This client has already broken the rules and it acted outside of their prescribed rule.
The rule? Rule?
This person tried to implicate another for the crime in order to save himself. And this is a trespass that cannot be forgiven.
Who gave you the right to be high and mighty?
To the gentleman who spoke just now. Excuse me, but would you care to die?
No, I didn't say anything!
Did you better watch yourself? We understand, so please tell us the name of your client. Client!
I'm afraid I cannot do that. I still have a few things to say before I do.
Egomaniac!
It's not good for your health to be aggravated. You won't live very long if you let everything bother you.
Somehow that coming from an assassin makes it less than comforting.
I don't really care about the extra little stuff. Just tell us to live already.
Patience. Try to calm down, I know. It's important to try and understand his mindset. He seems very steadfast and close to, so you are going to have to work together and talk. I'm not this therapist, you know.
Trust between you and your client?
I provide my service in a defensive manner. In exchange, I trust that my clients are discreet about me and my identity. These are the rules and duties of an assassin, and it's right to carry out.
I'm sorry, but I was wondering about something you said. You said that your client had already broken the rules.
A person of phrase on honor is the worst kind of human.
And that's why you feel so you can betray this person?
I have no trust relationship with a client who can't understand their assigned role.
Just my luck, an assassin with a consequence who would have figured.
Now then, everyone, do you think you can understand my logic?
This can just keep getting better and better.
If you can't, then I'm afraid we can proceed.
Everyone understands your point, I think, really.
In that case, I believe I'm prepared to disclose the information you seek.
You have made it crystal clear that you value trust over all else. I believe we are ready.
Excellent. And that is the reason I'm here today to witness. What is it?
No, I can't bring myself to ask the client of say name.
If you can't ask it, Miss Wright, then I will. Witness? What is the name of your client who requested the murder of your gorilla?
That person's name is...
Adrian Andrews.
Witness! That's not who you told me that was earlier.
Pay tell, what are you talking about, Mr. Prosecutor? I should think I know my own client, that is Adrian Andrews.
What? Wow! This
can be on the phone earlier.
What's going on here? My guess is that Mr. Killer just stabbed Mr. Edward in the back. Stabbed Edward in the back? I'm sure in order to get an audience with this court, Mr. Killer told him a different name. Metal Guard, perhaps. I knew it!
This is outrageous! I was deceived! This would be still a very serious lie. But you were the one of some of the
You shelled it together!
My testimony is the truth. The defendant at the moment is Metal Guard. I'm correct. All I wish to do is help her create his quick riddle.
Wow. All of a sudden it feels like we can't actually win this. Yeah.
The prosecutor also failed to provide a motive and instead provided a suicide note which is partially created by the victim. Furthermore, there is a possibility that the defendant himself knew it was fake. But most definitive of all, we have heard from the assassin himself that the name of his client, Mr. Kenny Clyde, who recounted the murder, was not the defendant at all.
No.
With all this evidence, it is obvious that to me that this means that Mr. Mastercard is innocent. I see that I caused you all a bit of confusion. Please continue the discussion and call me when you have reached a verdict.
Shoot!
Bailiff? Bailiff, please bring Mr. Adrian Andrews immediately!
What now? What now? With the way this is going, a guard will be found innocent. This may be our last chance to save Maya.
Yeah, but
Andrews is right. The kid is lying. And the guard, my client, I know he's guilty. Can I live with myself if I do with this?
Who would have believed that the prosecution or witness would absolve the defendant?
Your Honor, the prosecution requested permission to further question the witness. Shelly the killer is certainly lying under oath.
It wasn't me. Isn't everyone pleased? The testimony is not all would be lie. Miss Andrews, the suicide note may be fake, but the bad Matt! He's the reason Celeste died! I thought that it was all because he got pulled into Matt's twisted world! The testimony is now... You have to believe it. It was horrible, lie.
But Mr. Kinderson has testified. He named you as his client.
No, that's not true.
Also, there's quite a bit of evidence that points at you. The knife and button don't need to take a summer costume. But that's... you will have a motive. You know the business this impact was a large part of your life. You wanted to follow her, and you wanted revenge against the duo who hurt them. I would say you have plenty of reasons to want to get both dead. No... Mr. Wright! You know the truth. Tell them. Tell them the real story. What the regular is. Tell them. Please, help me. Yes, I know the truth.
Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor. I believe we have reached the end of this trial. Therefore, I ask the defense for final words or opinions.
I have to decide. Do I take the not guilty verdict and say my yeah? Or do I throw this chance away and wait for gumshoes, new evidence? What am I supposed to do? Felix? I can't do it by Mia. I can't accept you're not guilty. You're a lawyer. I know. But Malagor is a killer, a murderer. I can't let him get away with this. I can't let someone else take the fall. If I let Miss Andrews be convicted, then I'm not better than Edgard. And even though I don't want to admit it, I have to face fact. That is because of Edgard that I don't know the real truth. He could have gotten Edgard so many times over, but I never took a single one of those chances. If I take this verdict right now, I'd be betrayed by his trust.
His trust? I never thought about this until now. I trust him?
Yes, you do.
Mr. Wright, your opinion, please. The defense requests that we are allowed to further question Mr. the Killer. Am I here correct, Mr. Wright?
Right.
But... the witness has cleared your client through this testimony. Your job is here still.
I'm not done yet. To see through this witness lies and for the truth. That is my job, Your Honor.
There's still more evidence to look at. And I'm sure that once those pieces arrive here in this courtroom, a miracle will occur. Very well, the trial will continue. No objections there. Mr. Andrew, please re-establish connection with the Mr. Killer.
Right away, Your Honor.
Has the verdict reached?
Before that, we would like to talk with you a little more.
About? All you needed for me was the name of the client. What else could you need for me?
Actually, we would like to hear everything you know about this case. That is how things are. Usually done.
What is he talking about? Usually done?
But what should we have testify about?
Mr. Regular, if you don't mind, please testify about your client in more detail.
Your legal people and your procedures. Is there anyone who no one likes to go to court? As I already stated quite a few times earlier, address of a client, however, one thing I simply cannot overlook is tampering with the scene of the crime. My client needed to frame another for the crime. While pretending to be the first person to discover the body at the scene, Adrian Anderson knew from the very beginning that Miss Yokorina was dead. But even more appealing is the creation and planning of the knife and the button. That act is what I was referring to when I said my client had broken rules.
This is the most expected turn of events for the fifth time now. However, this time everything has finally revealed.
Just a second, Your Honor.
Yes, Mr. Short?
We still have a cross examination to do.
But you don't need to question testimony like this. Do you, Mr. Wright?
Your Honor, the defense will question the witness, as if he had a choice here.
Huh? Why? What is witness that you said is not but beneficial to the defense case? If you scrutinize the testimony that
they were exposed to lies, in that also beneficial testimony, I suppose.
I don't understand what's going on anymore.
Neither do I. That makes two of us. What is it, Mr. Wright?
If I press him in the wrong way, it might bear suspicion on his end.
But you have to do something to waste more time. With this, about requesting a hit?
Yes.
How much is your fee?
I see you're also quite a dark-hearted man, Mr. Tony.
Huh?
If you would like to talk about business, we can do so after trial.
No, not thinking of firing! Maybe Mr. Wright? Yes. You want to kill me? You want me dead? Don't you? What? Why would you take something like that? Your Honor, guilty, Mr. Wright, you are here for guilty!
With this, let's continue. What did you cross the name of your client? They are your clients, are you not? Are they not?
You want me guilty! Don't you! You want to kill me!
I would think that most people wouldn't be able to overlook a person hiring or to kill.
If you had a problem with such a thing, it wouldn't be very effective at my job.
Well, a change in occupation might be good for you.
Whoever will say this, even told them the one that does the deed, my clients are always the real guilty party.
That goes without saying, Mr. the Killer.
And the fate is to live with the knowledge of the guilt on their shoulders. However, my client this time thought that they could run away from the guilt.
Are you talking about the button and knife?
Yes, I'm a business card.
Oh, this card.
So that no one has to waste their time, including the police. They always make a point to make things as easy as possible.
You're trying to make things easy?
My business card makes it very easy to identify who carried out the service.
He's pretty devoted to his work.
Better to search everything to go and stab the deceased with a knife, and even hide my card from sight, so they cannot overlook.
It's really hard to tell if he's being truthful or not without me here.
Why pretend to be the first person discovered?
From the very beginning?
That is correct. Before my client visited the room, all of my clients know precisely what the situation is at all times.
I wonder if that's really true.
That's odd.
So why do you think your client did that?
What do you mean by why?
Well, fitting around the scene of the crime is pretty risky. So why would someone who has requested a murder go to the crime scene anyway?
That's true. I assumed it was probably done to frame Mr. Guard.
If that's the case, then why would did the person request that you do it?
Sadly, that is not possible.
Huh?
My job is to kill, that is all. I took the best business card behind the ashery. The business card is to so my client may escape blame, to protect them in my duty. If this is for revenge, send someone else up to take the fall.
And that's all you have to say? Testify?
Yes, and I pray that they will never be called to the stand again.
Again? I said you plan to continue?
I must, as I have yet to find a person to take my place, and become a force successor. Actually, how would you like a new life, Mr. Thorny?
Excuse me? No, I'm fine, really.
Are you really now?
I wonder what kind of man the judge thinks I am now. What are you going to do now, Phoenix?
All I can do now is expose the lies.
That's true. However, you realize that we'll be very bad for our client, right? I'm so confused. But the one thing I know for sure is that I can't let this right end yet.
Excuse me, I have to stop. Okay. Found out they had to press the use.
Thank you so much for taking the time to testify, Mr. Killer.
What is the meaning of that attitude?
When Adrian Andrews entered the victim's room, your client had no idea that Jokerino had been murdered.
But how would you know that?
From this wine glass, Your Honor.
The glass?
Mr. Killer supposed client thought Mr. Grinado faded. Which is why the glass of tomato juice was poured for the victim.
But is that just a part of Agent Andrews' calculated plan?
That is not possible, Your Honor. This glass bears the fingerprints of the person. Had this been planned, they would have never left their fingerprints behind.
I see your point. Mr. Edward, what is your opinion?
Strangely enough, I had the same exact thought just now. Witness, how do you explain this strange phenomenon?
Isn't it just a waste of time to ask about such a minor detail? It's not a very important point anyway, correct?
I'm afraid you are mistaken. If Adrian Andrews really is your client, as you claim, then your client should have had knowledge of Miss Corina's death. If not, then that knowledge means that Adrian Andrews was never your client at all.
How strange. Why is it that the attorney has yet to raise an objection at this absurd situation?
Phoenix, if they can figure out what we are up to, we are in great trouble.
Yeah, I know.
Mr. Edgeworth, I'm surprised. You know you can't say things like that without any evidence.
Sorry.
That sounded like an awfully weak objection to me.
Anyway. sorry. Anyway, I'm positive there was a contradiction in that testimony. The prosecution requested further testimony, considering which the request was taken.
Very well.
Right now we have to buy us more time. Why were we for the iris the killer left behind to get there? I just know that we are caught up in this trial lies with this item.
This request came to me, about a week ago. It was a request from a service on the night of the award ceremony. We met a certain bar to discuss the finalize of a few matters. That is what occurred. I trust my memory and I believe I have made no mistakes.
So you physically met your client, huh?
That is correct, meaning one's client is the one's first step to building trust, in my opinion.
I see. Well, Mr. Wright, your cross-examination, please. This request came to me about a week ago. Press everything.
1 week ago, I'm sure.
Yes, I'm quite sure. I, of course, had my own preparations. I have barely able to finish. When you request my services, Mr. Thorny, I hope you will keep that in mind.
Please, stop.
In any case, my client this time had a very specific date and time in mind.
a specific date and time? Did you ask why not on that specific night?
No. I tried to fulfill all the conditions for the client's request, but that's for why I only have my suspicions.
You're suspicious, huh? So what are the suspicions you had? Why did your client request that night?
I'm sure it was all for the bear.
Bear? The bear?
My client spoke of it. I'm sure there will be a bear-shaped figure in Joe Korea's room. I would like you, I'd like to retrieve the item for me.
You must be talking about the despair puzzle.
Indeed, that figure was a suicide note. Naturally, the victim brought it, put them into his hotel room. He was bound to publicly disclose the contents at the press conference, after all.
That is correct, and if he had not done a jump that night, I would not have known where the bear figure was.
I see.
Well, Miss Wright, wasn't this just of any importance?
That is only just us we want to clear. And that is... The client knew the secret of the bear figurine.
Why is everyone so quiet? Miss Wright, I think all of us thought we knew that.
Really? Would this please continue with your testimony? So you physically met Agent Andrews, right?
Of course you did.
What was that? What was the brief pause? Would this ever like to for you to give us some more, few more details?
I always meet my client as a matter of principle. I have never taken a request myself in the mail.
And why is that?
That's because I value the trust between our client and myself and all else. And the only one established it, that is to speak to client while looking at them in their eye.
Well, was right, was it as we used to know very important? Of course it was very important, Your Honor. If Mr. Killer had met this client before the murder, then it's not like he was mistaken.
So you say this is client really was Andrews?
Guess so.
You see, it is just as I said.
I'm so lost. Who the heck am I supposed to help me here? Calm down, Phoenix. Take carefully and relax.
No, will the witness please continue?
So your client was Agent Andrews?
That is correct.
Well, it says the two of them, but if they did, there should be anything wrong with this kind of sort of testimony.
Right, don't mess this up.
Well, there doesn't seem to be anything strange this time around. You had to draw more information from him, but you can't draw his suspicions. If you can do that, you should be able to find a flaw in his testimony somewhere. Talk about a delicate balance. Why Mrs. Kaiser is not important, and that wasn't the point. We're just pissed off sidestepping my questions.
What do you mean by that?
My question was, did you really meet Agent Andrews in person?
I already told you, Mr. Wright, I did. It was only through talking with him. It was only through talking with him face to face that I began to trust him. That's when I thought I could trust this person as a client.
It's true that they say something. Says about talking face to face. Well, Mr. Wright was not obvious of any importance. Oh, very important. If you hear what the Tinky heard just now, then I think you have got him. Your Honor, I believe the testimony just now was the utmost importance.
Huh? Really?
If that's the case, would this please conclude the statement just now in your testimony?
Very well.
him.
But as we know that that was not how it turned out, correct?
What do you mean?
Agent Harris turned out to be a client who couldn't stick to rules, right?
Well, yes. I suppose you're correct.
So I would like to check one last time. Are you sure your testimony is accurate?
Do it. I would like to go over this one more time. You met Adrian Andrews at bar and took the rest of the time?
Yes, that is correct.
And that's why you thought he was trustworthy?
How many times must I repeat myself? Yes, that is correct.
I'm sorry, but that is an impossible tale.
What?
Shelly the killer. You had never met the real Adrian Andrews.
Why would you say that?
Because you made one very big slip up about her.
So what is the issue? What did you say now? About her?
If you had ever met any adversary person, one look would have told you that she was a woman.
Oh no! Oh no! Oh no!
Mr. Wright, what is the meaning of this? This pretty just testified to the folly that he always meets face to face with his clients when they take his request.
But that's never met every address in person.
Yes, Your Honor, that is exactly the point. That means Mr. Decatur's client could only be Miss Adrian Andrews.
Ew, he's sweating oil.
Mr. Ash, what the hell is your logic on this one? However, why would an assassin make such a basic mistake?
I believe that is to do with her name, Your Honor.
Her name?
Yes, Agent Andrews is pushed out of a very atrocious name.
Yes, I see.
Unluckily for Mr. the Killer, the entire time he was on the stand, no one has stated Agent Andrews together. And so he simply picked the together to go with.
What? What's going on? Shelly the killer! This got to pass on the explanation!
I think so. I must have mixed up this client and put her on her.
So does that mean that you're different now?
Yes, of course. Please, if you will allow me to testify once more.
And now he's going to spit out the more lights.
Well, this time, please give us the truth and not the bare truth.
Yes, I remember. I took the request by mail. There have been many times when I took a job without having met with my client. The request was for the murder of your career and three other small things. When I saw the name at the end of the letter, I thought that my client was to be a man.
So you took the job through letter? You didn't mention anything about a letter in your testimony, which means you're definitely lying. Be careful, Phoenix. If you break the assassin's testimony completely, it's over for us. I know, I can't make you suspicious, but I think we're okay. Like we can do this. As long as he's standing there across the from me. No matter how strong of a punch I throw, I will counter him. He will counter it.
No, Dad, let's begin the cross examination.
Okay, I think we're edit here, so... Oh my god, this is really difficult. This is to cross-examine the client. Anyways, thank you for watching, leave a comment, subscribe if you liked it, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye!